Yes, my check.
The man who introduced you, spoke of your offer in immediate realization, and I'll admit being surprised in hearing that offer. Could you go into more detail about that, please? I was surprised about the immediate aspect of it. I thought realization was meant to require long and hard work.
You have to work very hard. You thought that. All right, it's a good idea because all of us think that way. Nothing new. Everybody thinks that. How can you get it so easily? You do get it, no doubt, but how? Maybe I know the trick. Must be something special about me. I'm supposed to do this. I know it. All right? They talk. You see, somebody was in California. He cut their tongues, can you imagine? Push it back into here. That's called as Khechari Avastha. Imagine cutting the tongue here. And now these old people are wagging their tongues just like dogs in India. They are still there. The fellow is dead and gone. See, he was talking of Kriya Yoga. He's gone now. But these people have their tongues down below, no sort of self-realization, nothing. People have been standing on their heads, no self-realization, nothing. Now I'll tell you one simple thing. One must know that we did not do anything to become human beings, did we? So if I have to become superhuman beings, also we don't have to do anything. Because it's a living process. What do we do for living process? Very simple thing. If you want to germinate a seed, you put it in the Mother Earth. She knows all the job. And she does it for you. Do you do anything? Do you stand on your head? Or do you run? Or do you have any sort of a physical exercise to see that the seed germinates? Nothing. It's a living process. For living process, you don't have to do anything yourself. But after realization, this is a unique thing. After a human being gets his realization, then he feels the power flowing through. He's no more an animal, no more an inanimate thing. Like this machine doesn't know I'm speaking in it. It doesn't know it is carrying the electricity. Least of all, it can not do anything by itself. But here, you know the power is flowing through you. You know, you will know how to maneuver it. Also, you will be completely in charge of it. That's what I'm saying. It's fantastic, isn't it? But for a song, what's the harm? It's for a song. Yes, I agree. It is said that you have to do this. Even Kundalini awakening, God. I've read a book so big as that. I mean, I couldn't read all that nonsense, but in that book, they said the Kundalini is in the stomach. Can you imagine? Anything, you see, God, about God, Hitler can write, Napoleon can write, anybody can write. But I have to deliver the goods. I have to. Say I'm a banker and I've got the key with me, which I have to return to. That's all. Another simple example I'll say, that this candle is enlightened and that one is not, supposing. Then just this light has to go near that because it is ready-made. But if I can't see, I don't know anything about it, I may take this enlightened light or may not take this enlightened light, do all kinds of things which may be absurd. And that's why you go on like that. Like from the village, say, Indian village, those who have not seen electricity, they come and you tell them put off the light. They'll go and start blowing at it, you see. And the whole night they'll be blowing. And they'll say, it is very difficult to blow off this light because they don't know the trick. Mystery of the Christian churches, they'll talk of mystery. What is the mystery then? Because you don't know anything, so call it a mystery. Very nice. There's nothing mysterious. You will see everything clearly. You will see everything happening clearly. You can see the rising of the Kundalini, you can see flowing of it, but they don't want to accept. They are too vain. That's what it is. Same with every sort of religious person. It's not with one, but they are also vain. They do not want to accept it. And they will be losing all the chances. The chance is now, the time is now. Because they want to carry on with that still. Yes, you must know that in India, in the villages, there are thousands of surgeries, thousands, you see. The more westernized you are, the more developed you are less prone to reality. You prefer plastic more than reality, I think. And that's how there are less people. But very good quality of Sahajogis we have in the West. Very good quality. Because they are intelligent, logical. Once they have found the truth, they stick on to it. And they work it out. They are very intelligent people. You really need pure intelligence to understand this. But if you have a biased mind, then it is rather difficult. But still, when it works out, how far can you go and deny it? Best thing is that you are a seeker and you must seek it. Supposing I have done the cooking, forget it how I have done it, better have it. If you are hungry, you will eat it, isn't it? You have to eat it. You have to taste it, not me.